David Faustino.
Hello, this is Andrew Chalmers, the writer and doctor in Doctor Who, Doctor.
This is Dr. Steve-o.
Everybody, this is the Cavernator.
This is Inspector Gadget.
Hey, what's cracking, y'all? It's your boy, J-Rock.
Good evening, folks. This is James Duval.
This is Jeremy Taggart.
This is Kim Possible.
I'm Chris Holden-Lee.
Hey, this is Pat Mastriani from Degrassi.
This is the evil Dr. Badfox.
Again, this is Missy Bear.
And this is Worf from X-Men.
Hey, this is Andrew Gazzess.
This is Sean Gunn.
Hi, this is Robert Carradine.
It's Tammy Stronach from The Neverending Story.
Hey, it's Zach Callison.
Hey, I'm DJ Jenny Rob.
And I'm Neil Young.
I'm Commander Shepard.
Ralph Garman here. You're listening to Droids Canada. You've made an excellent choice. You have chosen wisely.
Warning. Listener discretion is advised.
Hello.
I love Little Michael.
Everybody loves Little Michael.
He broke in my nose.
You know who also likes Little Michael? Baby Brain!
Oh, no.
Baby Brain.
Hello.
Hello. Oh, we are in the studio. In my apartment.
In the apartment.
I didn't screw up today.
No, you didn't.
We're going to get pretty serious today, guys. So what we're going to do, we're going to have to just take this guy here. I'm going to do this a little bit. Down we go. Down, 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 down.
That's right.
Down.
Down you go.
Shaken.
Anyways, sorry. I actually scared Dan a little bit.
No, that makes me think of that that video that was on the internet a little way back.
There's a lot
back.
Of videos on the
There's a lot of them, but there's that one. It was some sort of a protest that goes on, and then there's some goth guy in the background, and as soon as everyone's quiet, he goes, "Hail Satan!" He has a sign.
On that note, over to Mark. Oh, here we go.
Thanks, guys. You can find their award-nominated podcast that is recorded in Todd's studio, in his apartment, on the following: the Tangent Bound Network, Spotify, Laughable Podcast Network, iTunes, Google Play, Stitcher Radio, Electronic Media Collective, Podbean, and the Points of Interest Network. And of course, you can find us on our social media, on the Facebooks at Droids Canada. You can find us on the Twitter at Droids Canada, on Instagram at the_droids_Canada. And the final place for all your geek needs at droidscanada.com. That's it for me. Back to you guys.
Ooh, you like that transition.
That was a
you like
that exceptional... Oh, thanks, Mark. So, what is this that we are listening to throughout our show?
Well, this is... Dan, how do I put this? Our very public protest of the firing of James Gunn.
Well, there was the firing of James Gunn, and then there was the discussion of James Gunn coming back, and then there was the cast with the letter of support for...
The letter of support.
The letter of support?
Supporting of the letter.
For James Gunn.
For James Gunn.
And then the Disney bringing him back to discuss with James Gunn. And then Disney's final decision, bye-bye, James Gunn.
Serious thought, though. Did you know he had a pedophile-themed party? Now you know.
That is, like, seriously?
Yes. Like, I heard about that after the fact.
Like, what would you do?
It's, I don't know. It was some really weird... It was a gag party. It was just a joke. That was during this whole time when he was doing all these jokes and... Okay. You know, like, what? I'm going to give Disney this. That was completely out of bounds right there.
Yo, 100%.
Especially when you're dizzy, you don't want to find out that little Mickey got fondled. You know what I mean?
No, I'm, you know what? More jokes start coming into my head, but I'm just deflecting.
Put up your deflector shield.
Exactly, exactly. Those are those,
stay on topic.
There's lines you don't
stay cross. On topic. Porkins, pull up. Stay on topic. I see a subway everywhere.
So with I don't know. Like
you said, there was going to be a rant. I'm waiting.
Well, no, I have something I do want to get off my chest.
Off
that
your
has
chest.
Absolutely nothing to do with this.
Oh, I thought this was this.
No. This is something else.
Oh. Did you know there used to be videos of girls farting bubbles?
You gotta pull that up.
It was like a really weird fetish. My friend's brother, I say his name, it doesn't matter. And this is when... No. It was like fountains of... Like they would fill up their anal cavity full of bubble juice. Is that what you call it?
Bubble juice?
Okay.
So like the like blown bubbles.
Yes. Yes. They would fill.
See,
up.
I thought you meant like being in the bathtub and you hear dunk dunk.
No. No. That is definitely not it.
Okay.
No, it was just weird. I think it was called cake farts.
Cake farts. Two greatest words to ever be put together.
Seriously. Hold on. Buy me some time. Talk about your thing.
That has completely derailed me from my anger towards something.
Go ahead, find it.
I started with... Now, there's something that I want to get off my chest, okay?
It's definitely not cake farts.
It's not cake farts. So, I have... Jesus Christ. So... I'm a very positive guy. I'm not really that negative a guy, but I have lately had a couple of things that have kind of bothered me a little bit. So there's one thing that I want to say that I really, really, really fucking hate, and that's cellophane.
What?
I fucking hate cellophane.
Okay, wait.
Especially in the summer.
Okay, hold on. Wait. Can we just have a moment? Can you relax for just a minute?
Yeah, but you told me to...
I wasn't ready for this. I didn't know you were going to go that far.
Okay. Oh, here we go.
Damn it. No, what is happening?
All right.
That's fine.
Yeah, I know what's coming. I know what's coming. Yeah, that's it right there.
So just a minute, guys. I got to do a little bit of a...
Yeah, a little bit on the fly here.
A little bit of a transition.
A little bit on the fly.
I got to do a little bit of a transition. Hold on.
Transitioning. There we go.
Cellophane.
I hate fucking cellophane.
To tell.
So, what happened?
What?
What happened to Enya?
It's still there. It's just that I'm kind of pulled on the cord.
What happened, like, cellophane in the summer fucking sucks.
Okay.
Because anytime you have anything that has cellophane wrapped around it, it just fucking sticks to you. And you try to fucking shake it off your hand, and then it sticks to your arm. I just hate
some
cellophane.
Real first world problems happening right now.
Hashtag first world
problems.
We
can't get a box of Kraft dinner to Africa, and you're worried about cellophane sticking to your skin.
I don't like cellophane.
Oh my god.
Why don't you use paper?
It's just as bad as the other day. I watched someone fucking cook pizza with... I understand. No, I understand, Dan. I understand the purpose.
I hate cellophane.
Okay. It's this thing, by the way.
It's the cord.
That's the cord.
You gotta get some new cords.
Okay, good.
Hopefully they don't come in a package with cellophane in it.
But I understand. But I have never seen anyone in my entire life put pizza on newspaper and then microwave it.
Yeah, totally.
Never.
Newspaper absorbs.
I get that part when it goes down to fish and chips. I understand.
That was Louis Fish and Chips on Main Street. Well, and they used to wrap it in that. And another thing.
But that's deep fried oils, man. We're talking about a fucking pizza, and you deep fried fucking fish, and then you threw it in the basket. That makes sense to me because you're trying to soak up the oils and the grease. I understand that. But you are literally taking a piece of pizza that has been pre-cooked, cold. Yes. Mm-hmm. I give up.
And when you heat it on top of the newspaper will suck out the grease. Another good use for newspaper would be Windex. If you ever want to clean the windows nice, crumple up a piece of newspaper, spray the Windex on the window, and away you go. No streaks. No streaks. Now, take
There's
it away.
There's like a video from Toronto, and this is what started it all.
Okay.
Would you believe it's from Toronto? Hold on. Hold on. I'm going to transition now. Are you done with cellophane?
Yeah. Fuck you, cellophane.
Okay.
Hopefully there's no one out there who's named cellophane, like a artist or something. Because not you. I just the plastic.
Cake farts. A website featuring a Toronto-based woman, Leah Tracy, hunched over a cake and passing gas. It was produced by then her boyfriend, Wayne Schiff.
It's got to be a Wayne.
Who posts on YouTube within minutes, traffic overwhelmed the site as hundreds of thousands of people were attempting to trick their friends into watching a woman farting over a cake.
No, that's not what it was.
That's not what it was. Oh. When a man or a woman nuzzles the entrance of their anus into a freshly caked, cooked cake, then lifts a little bit. Rather disgusting website where a girl gets naked and farts with her ass buried in the cake. That's not what I saw. That's not what I saw. You know what? If I can ever find the video, okay. I will fucking show
okay,
you.
Okay, Urban Dictionary, type in fart bubble.
Oh, really? I just turned it off.
Okay, never mind.
Okay, so let's go back to Guardians of the Galaxy.
Guardians of the Galaxy. We'll be listening to this soundtrack. Now, with everything that's happened with Senor Gunn, Mr. James Gunn, who will not be involved with Guardians 3, and the very, very public Dave Bautista... saying he won't be a part of it. Did he say he won't be a part of it? Like, I read it and I don't remember.
He said
the exact,
he would not.
I don't want to quote.
No, he would not be a part of it. No.
Without his script.
I don't know if it was that detailed.
I think it was the script. So if it is James Gunn's script and someone else, will Bautista still be portraying Drax the Destroyer? Or will he not?
Maybe it's going to be an I Love No Name character.
The what?
Maybe it's going to be Brian Bautista filling in.
Could be.
His third cousin to the left. Like, I mean, Hulk Hogan had a cousin named Horace.
Horace Hogan?
Yes. In the NWO.
Oh, Jesus.
I don't think they actually were related, though.
No, that's... What, is that called kayfabe?
Kayfabe. Well, they actually used
kayfabe.
To...
Kayfabe?
Brutus Barber Beefcake used to say he was Hulk Hogan's brother.
No, that's because Hulk Hogan used to be like, I got Brutus Beefcake, brother! That's why.
Fart bubble.
Fart bubble.
A bubble that stubbornly resides within the chambers of your anus that requires extra force of bowels release, usually resulting in a fart amplified 5 to 10 times in loudness.
So it's like, pah-hum.
Everyone knows the fart bubble when it gets stuck in like the crevice between your navel and your leg, and it sits there and it splashes up against your fucking leg. And you're like, ugh, it's wet. You have to go home and take a shower after, just in case.
Oh god, fart bubbles.
Oh man, you have nowhere to go, especially when you're wearing tight jeans. That's why I understand these kids when they're like, oh, I better get me some skinny jeans. Your fart has nowhere to go.
Don't, they just go back
like
in.
When you were a kid, Dan, do you remember wearing those ski suits? Like the big snowman suits?
Ski suits?
Yeah, what are they called again? Snowmobile pants and stuff like that.
Like winter, like snow pants?
Yeah, snow pants, yeah.
Yeah, like when you'd walk and go
Okay, but where does what does heat do?
What does heat do?
Yes, it rises, does it not?
It does.
Where does you think the fart goes?
It's going to go up to your neck.
You're going to be chewing it after you
it
fart.
It should be called neck farts.
Neck farts.
Neck farts. It happens usually when you're in Canada or some sort of northern or extreme
Maybe
southern
Alaska.
Country. And when you're wearing your full winter garb and you are properly layered, so you're nice and toasty warm even though it's cold out, and you've had a nice hot chili or something to, you know, warm the cockles, and then you have to have a fart bubble which rises up the suit and comes out the little spot in the neck. It's almost like Dutch ovening yourself. Fart bubble. Is that okay? Or does that actually come in? Like
what?
Wow. They actually have that already?
Well.
So we were discussing with the James Gunn, you know, stuff that's going on. Disney, yay or nay on the James Gunn, what do you think?
They definitely said nay.
They did say nay.
They weren't going to do it.
Well, they said nay. What do you say? If you were Todd Disney, what would you do? Would you say, James, welcome back to the fold? Or would you say, you know what? Enough's enough. You know, pedo party.
Looks like I'm just reading. It looks like there's some backpedaling happening here.
Oh, there's backpedaling? It's got to be backpedaling. Because you got to think, you know, even though he's in a...
You know what it is? You know what that reminds me of? And I know, I hate going into politics, man. I hate talking about politics.
I love
all those fucking celebrities are like, Donald Trump gets into the White House. I'm going to move to Canada.
I'm moving to Canada.
And Canada's like, no.
Where's Whoopi?
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
Whoopi Goldberg should be in Canada right now. Miley Cyrus should be in Canada right now. Who else should be in Canada?
Yes, if I have any responses.
I like Whoopi.
When he was asked if, when he was asked by a fan how he would respond to Disney if Gunn was not reinstated, he stated, and I quote, as per the Twitter!
Uh-oh.
This is from his Twitter. I will do what I'm legally obligated to do, but Guardians without James Gunn is not what I signed up for. Guardians of the Galaxy without James Gunn isn't just Guardians of the Galaxy. It's also pretty nauseating to work for someone who'd empower a smear campaign by fascists and cyber Nazis.
Yo, wow. Okay, so he just...
But he did say he wouldn't return, though. I remember him saying that.
So now it's that he just won't like it. But
so this could be Drax's last Guardians film.
Yes, I honestly think after this one, there won't be another one.
I don't know. I didn't think, because I remember the rumor for the longest time is that Chris Evans wouldn't stay for Captain America after the third Captain America movie, i.e. Civil War.
Yes.
But he's still got a couple more left to go. Like, Infinity Wars, he's got the next Infinity one, and I think there's still one more after that.
No, they said that this Infinity Wars was going to be his last one, but there still is the next Infinity Wars.
Well, yeah, part two.
Part two.
Duo.
Yeah. Yeah.
I was looking for an article to see if anyone has actually made a list of people who could replace him. Because, you know, the internet.
We should come up with our own list.
Oh, God.
People who would replace Guardians of the Galaxy actor Dave Bautista.
Let me check the internet.
Is it Bautista or Bautista? Because Bautista, that's like the, you know, the bat flip. You know what? Bautista. He's not really doing anything right now, is he? Jose Bautista?
Okay, hang on. Oh!
With the booster juice?
Thank you, Looper.
Oh, Looper.
Good movie.
So, this is the
27 actors you didn't know were almost cast in Guardians of the Galaxy.
Oh.
Tom Cruise is going to be Green Lantern, I read.
You think so?
No, he's not tall enough.
I think it's a big mistake.
Oh! Glenn Howerton is Star Lord?
Who's that?
Oh, what was he in? Always Sunny in Philadelphia.
Okay.
Fucking Jim from The Office? No.
As Star-Lord? No.
Gina Carrero's Gamora? No.
No.
Isaiah Mustafa as Drax the Destroyer, also known as the Old Spice Guy.
Yep.
You believe that one?
I would do it in a second.
Jason Momoa as Drax the Destroyer.
Nope.
He's fucking awesome in anything he does.
Yeah, but I would rather take the Old Spice Guy.
Oh, Hugh Laurie should have been in this film. Adam Sandler or Jim Carrey could have been Rocket Raccoon.
No.
Wow, these are some...
You're scrolling too quick.
Because I'm looking for just Drax. Oh, Zachary Levi as Star-Lord. Fucking Jim Sturgis as Star-Lord. Who the fuck is Lee Pace?
More people... Star-Lord's the guy. He's the guy.
Star-Lord.
Star-Lord.
Technically, Venom was the leader of the Guardians of the Galaxy 1.2.
Venom?
Yep. All right, let's go to the slideshow here, guys.
We're going to slideshow it up.
I knew, but Joseph Gordon-Levitt is Star-Lord.
You know what? They really should have continued the Batman trilogy and had him do a Nightwing movie.
Eddie Redmayne?
Don't know him. If he kicked me in the shin, I'd be like, what are you doing, guy? Kicking me in the shin? I don't know you.
I don't even know who that is.
Who's this guy? Who's this fucking guy?
It's over there. Over there. Over there.
He looks stupid.
Look at that guy in his fucking haircut. Yonkers. Aaron Paul. So you're saying Jesse from Breaking Bad could have been Star-Lord? He'd been like, science, bitch! And then shot somebody, and no one will believe it.
Could have been.
Cam Giggity?
Giggity.
What is your fucking name, dude? Get a new name. Okay, we're still on Star-Lord. I don't want Star-Lord.
Still on Star-Lord. Next.
Still on Star-Lord. Still on
next.
Star-Lord. Is there any 27 actors that have been in the film?
Next. So, now we're going to get to some Star-Lord.
Still. Who's wait. Guy? Oh, no, that's Ronan. Still waiting.
So while we're still while you're, on while Star Wars, clickety click click machine over
click,
here.
Click 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 click.
I'm
click,
going to see. I hate fucking next buttons.
They just do it so they fucking troll. Troll.
Yeah, but I hate Cellophane more.
Really?
I do. So
the great Cellophane.
So who would be my number one?
Yeah, who would be your number one?
Who would be my number one to replace Bautista? Not Jose Bautista, because he's not doing anything. I would say, who would I have replaced Bautista? You know who I think could have made a good Star-Lord?
Who?
Corey Feldman.
Get the fuck out of my apartment. Oh my god, we finally moved on to Gamora.
Oh, Gamora's... Okay.
Olivia Wilde, 13. Oh, what's her face from fucking S.H.I.E.L.D.? Agents of Shit.
Who? Hold on.
That's fucking mocking something, whatever.
Oh, okay. She was also in Friday Night Lights.
Yes.
Yeah.
Rachel Nichols? I don't know who that is, but goddamn. Yeah, Gina Carrera. She scares me, man. I don't want to get punched by that chick. Oh, Charlotte Copley. That guy makes me laugh so hard.
Who is that?
He's known for District 13 and Hardcore Henry.
Okay.
Hardcore Henry is a fantastic film.
I saw District 13.
I don't know if David Tennant could have been good. He's the Doctor. Rocket Raccoon.
See, Jim Carrey? No.
Adam Sandler's Rocket Raccoon?
Definitely not.
Oh my god, imagine that. It'd be like all dick and fart jokes.
Right,
and then somehow you'd have to find a way to write in fucking David Spade in so he didn't feel left out.
No, it would be Rob Schneider.
Or Rob Schneider. You'd be like, you can do it, Rocket! Tear his fucking arms off!
Rocket and Groot, you guys have been arrested for doing this bad things and that he didn't do it! Okay, so Old Spice Guy?
Okay, so it's Old Spice Guy and Momoa, so that's
those
it.
Those are the only two others that
okay,
were
so,
considered.
Okay, let's okay. Okay.
If I had to pick,
so we gotta think about
old,
this.
If I had
you know what,
pick
who
between
pick?
Old Spice Guy and Momoa, I would pick Old Spice Guy.
What? Fucking 100%. Momoa can kill him. Power. Terry Crews, motherfucker.
Terry Crews.
Terry Crews beats everybody.
Terry Crews does trump all.
He's the best. Okay. Okay.
So,
what about
put our minds together? And
what about Tony
list.
Little? Tony Little.
He's too intense.
What are you talking about? So.
Drax is. He's too intense. Where Drax is more kind of. He's invisible.
Okay. Nathan Jones.
I don't know who that is.
Nathan Jones.
Vinny Jones?
No, not Vinny Jones.
Fucking soccer hooligan?
No, it's no. How about Jason Statham?
Jason Statham. You know what?
I just saw The Meg tonight.
You know what? Jason Statham, but the accent would kind of throw it. Can he speak? Can you speak American?
You know how many girls he would lay as Drax?
Everyone's showing up with fucking gray paint on them with little red flecks. Oh, Jesus.
God.
I don't know about Jason Statham.
Okay.
The accent. The accent would just fucking kill
it. I got it. JCVD.
No.
Van Damme.
I can't stand
Van Damme.
Him.
Okay, so he's got to be a big dude, so we got to like eliminate a lot of people like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, not Van Damme. Van Damme's like a little guy. He's like Tom Cruise size, like step on a box. He's a little guy. Okay, Drax the Destroyer. Who would I use?
How about
as?
That Asian guy from every Jean-Claude Van Damme film that's super built?
Oh, what's his name?
I don't remember his name.
I know who you're talking about.
But, good, but Brick, don't hit back.
Brick, don't hit back.
It's a very valid point.
Now I break you like I break your friend.
Yes.
Point to the bandana.
Point to the bandana.
Jackson's bandana.
Ogre. Okay, Frank Dukes? No, Dukes.
Like, put up your Dukes. you the American asshole who make trick with Brick. It's a great play.
Oh, my great God.
Play. Okay, I always thought that Paco...
Do you even podcast, bro?
I always thought that Paco should have done better. The Muay Thai guy.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, I thought he should have done better. He was dirty.
Take it back.
Dirty
okay, Drax. We have to replace Drax at this point.
We're replacing Drax right now.
Because he's going to be out of a job, and you know they're going to make at least 7 fucking Guardians films to milk this one dry.
So, I'm going to go in a similar yet different direction. I'm going to use another former WWE superstar.
Are you going to say The Croc?
No. Bad News Barrett.
Bad News Barrett.
Bad News Barrett has been in a few films in just small roles and whatnot.
Know.
You know what?
I've got some bad news.
That was a good angle. I actually didn't mind that. In the King Barrett angle, I didn't mind it at all.
No, the bad news is better. When he would sit...
They hit him with the ball hammer.
What is that?
Oh, it's a
form? When he would be in this lift and perch above everyone and laugh at them, that was great. The only thing that would be better...
Have you
seen stuff
Dean
at
Ambrose? He's huge.
Yeah,
he came back from injury and he's jacked.
You know what? I did see him with a new haircut, a new bad attitude, and maybe they just waited until the steroids were out of his system to pass a piss test.
Oh, I see what you did there.
So,
now he's pulling a Brock. Brock Lesnar. Brock Lesnar is Drax. He won't like the recording. He won't like the traveling.
He wouldn't like the whole concept of it. And
the traveling to and from a green
really
screen is tiring.
You'd really have to airbrush out the big tattoo on his chest.
Yeah, the big giant penis
stupid
on his chest.
Knife tattoo.
I don't even know what that is. I don't even know. Whoever. He has a tramp stamp, eh?
He has a tramp stamp, too.
He does have a tramp stamp.
Is that why he wears high tights?
Yes.
So people wouldn't be like, dude.
Correct. He has tribal tramp stamp. I didn't believe it until I think it was when he was wrestling Goldberg, and it just came down just a little bit much. You're like, he's got a fucking tramp stamp. I don't know how to react to that. Like, you know, to each their own. I have tattoos, and people can make fun of me for having tattoos, I suppose. But I remember one time working at the gym. This guy, he's not jacked, but I mean, he obviously loves his arm days and his chest days, forgets legs.
Got chicken legs?
He's got chicken legs. It always blows my mind, man, the little chicken legs. My legs are pretty huge. I'm going to admit that. They're pretty muscular.
It's like a ripped up orange on a toothpick.
Yes.
Because he got two legs. You know?
So, this guy goes up, he's doing chin-ups, and I guess as he came down on the force, his shirt kind of came up, and he has a full, like, tribal... Like, this is something you would see on the back of an 18-year-old freaking high schooler trying to get into a fucking club. Girl, by the way. And it's, like, all the way down his back onto his hip bone. I'm like, huh. It feels weird now.
A little bit. While you were saying that, I was thinking about...
tramp stamp.
The guy who should play Drax.
Okay.
Now...
Does he have a tramp stamp?
I don't know. I have not seen his lower back.
Well, we can look it up.
Or his ribs. Now, I don't know his name.
Well, that makes it kind of hard, Danny.
But I know a couple things he was in.
What?
He was in Jericho. And he was in...
Skeet Ulrich?
No. He was in Jericho. He was also in Breaking Bad... Bald guy. Intense. Older. Okay. I'll find his name. I got his name. Okay. It's a race. Okay. Okay. You win.
Gerald McRaney?
Hold on.
You mean Lenny James from Walking Dead?
No.
Michael Gaston. The old guy?
Maybe it wasn't Jericho he was in.
I don't think so. Oh my god, Richard Spite was in Jericho? I didn't know that. Well, he probably was, and I should have known that.
Alright, here we go. It's coming up.
Still waiting.
No, it wasn't Jericho. It wasn't Jericho.
That's
it
a great show. That show should have got... Totally. You know what pisses me off? Look at these ratings. 92% on Google, 8 out of 10 on IMDb, 8.8 out of 10 by TV.com.
Okay, so...
Rotten Tomatoes, 89%.
Yep.
And they still canceled this show.
It was writer's strike, man. It was writer's strike.
Doesn't matter. They can still bring it up. It's funny. If you look up and find that picture of us and Lenny James... Where is he? Where is Lenny James? Right there. Read the sign. Hashtag bring back Jericho.
I can't see...
He loved it.
Who was it?
Lenny James. Morgan.
Okay, Morgan, yeah.
He was in Jericho. He loved it. He goes, yeah, I totally bring back Jericho. That was a great show.
It was a good show. It was a really good show.
I still have it on DVD. It's one of the only things I have left on DVD.
So,
okay, we're still waiting.
Dean Norris.
Who? Shit. The brother-in-law.
Dean Norris.
Yeah, brother-in-law.
Hank. And Breaking Bad. Tony in Total Recall. Total Recall.
Total Recall.
Under the Dome. Get the Gringo.
He's kind of old now.
What's that? He is kind of old, but he's intense.
How about Tom Hardy?
Tom Hardy can do anything, but how many people can you play? You can't be that many people.
Technically,
he
was a clone of Patrick Stewart in the most horrible Star Trek movie ever created, Insurrection.
That was pretty bad.
But he was still in it. And he looked like a very young Patrick Stewart. Pulled it off.
Yeah.
I mean, can you really name a bad movie with Tom Hardy?
What movies has he been in? I know lots that he's been
really
in.
Pull up a fucking IMDb page right
now?
Yes,
oh
my
do.
God. God damn it, Dan.
I could always pull it up.
No, it's fine. I got it. I wouldn't want to tire you out.
Well, yeah, it's all this clicking and buttons and shit. There's got to be something that's not that good on that list.
Well, I'm sure there's going to be a bad movie rating that I probably never heard of. It's probably some like this indie film that no one ever heard of.
Screw the rating system. If I like the movie, I like the movie. Now let's get to these movies. What is he known for?
Well, okay.
I can't even see that.
That's fine. That's fine. You don't need to see that.
He was Bane.
He was Bane. Okay. Well,
he was
nearly
adopted the doctor. All right. I was born in it.
He was in Band of Brothers.
Band of Brothers. That's that series, HBO, right?
Yep.
The Army.
Great show.
Yeah.
He was also in Black Hawk Down.
Black Hawk Down is a great movie.
I was incorrect. It's Star Trek Nemesis, not Insurrection.
Nemesis?
Nemesis. That was the
Nemesis.
Last one.
Nemesis. Yeah.
That was the last one when Data blew up himself and gave them the other Data. I don't know. It was pretty bad. It was the last Next Generation movie they made.
Is that the one where Kirk died?
No, that was Generations.
Oh, okay.
All these movies I've never heard of before. Literally...
Hold on.
I don't know. Virgin Queen? What the fuck's that? I don't know. Sweeney Todd. Well,
it wasn't
Sweeney Todd the movie. It was a TV show.
He was Theo in Minotaur.
What the fuck is a Minotaur?
Minotaur. Minotaur is a guy with a horse legs.
No, you don't even know the movie.
No, Minotaur. Is a Minotaur a guy with a horse legs and a human body? Or is it a bullhead and human legs?
I'm just trying to see how many movies I've actually seen with him in it. Okay, I've seen Sucker Punch.
What's a Minotaur?
Anyways, I've also seen Rock and Rolla, which is one of Guy Ritchie's last films. He made a couple films after that, but I actually liked Rock and Rolla because it was more of a throwback to Snatch.
So this is when he was with
this
Madonna,
Madonna? I don't know. Bronson, that was a good movie.
Like Charles Bronson?
Yeah, it was about Charles Bronson.
Damn.
Inception? Inception.
I haven't seen it.
Really?
Nope.
No, there's funny. There's an article on the internet right now that explains the ending that just came out today. Tinker, Tailor, Soldier, Spy. I have not watched it, but that movie apparently Gary Oldman won a ton of awards for. Warrior, fantastic film.
Warrior, that's a fighting movie.
That's a UFC movie.
Okay.
This Means War was a comedy. That was pretty good. I haven't watched Lawless. Heard it was good. Oh, the Bane and the Dark Knight Rises. Never seen Lock. Never seen The Drop. Never seen Child 44. Mad Max. Fury Road. Did you see that?
Nope.
He like had two lines in that whole film. Legend, that was
Did
good.
Did he have more lines in Mad Max than Brendan Fraser had in G.I. Joe?
Pretty much.
That guy's a Joe.
Technically. The Revenant. You know the movie that Leonardo DiCaprio finally won an award, an Oscar for?
Didn't see it.
Had to get raped by a bear to get it?
Didn't see it.
Dunkirk. Christopher Nolan war movie. We were talking about it the other day.
Didn't see it.
Peaky Blinders apparently is a very popular show that's still on Netflix. I don't know what Sticky is. I don't know what Taboo. Venom post-production looks good. He apparently put a shit ton of weight on for Al Capone and Fonzo. And I know he's going to make another Mad Max movie.
All right, then. He's a busy guy.
He is very busy. He's not The Rock, though.
Exactly.
Not The Rock.
So
that reminds me, I got to download Ballers this week.
Would Vin Diesel... double the role?
No.
And?
Fuck Vin Diesel.
Do you like Vin Diesel?
I do not like Vin Diesel.
Why, because of The Rock?
Partially.
Okay.
But literally, watch all his films, and he wears the same clothes.
Yeah, 100%. 100%.
Oh, sorry. Pitch Black. They spray painted the wife beater and the fucking khakis to black.
Khakis.
You just get your fucking khakis. Wait, I'll start that again. I ain't bleeping out what you're saying on that one.
Oh, fuck.
Okay, so we're coming up to the end of this show. Dan, what's your final thoughts in terms of David Bautista?
I still haven't even...
How about Dave Bautista wrapped in cellophane?
No. Oh, fucking cellophane.
As Drax.
So...
James Gunn's directing it.
I haven't. Other than Dean... Is his name Dean Norris?
Dean Norris.
What about Dean Cain?
Fuck Dean Cain. He's an asshole.
Okay. Michael Ironside.
Maybe 20 years ago.
20 years ago? Yeah, he's a bit too old
He terrified me. When I met him in Montreal, I told him he scared the shit out of me. He laughed at me.
We still haven't gotten our definite... We need our Droids Canada picks as Drax 2.0.
I think we should take some time to research this.
What about Daniel Tosh?
That'd be fucking hilarious.
Might as well get Hannibal Buress a chance to throw his name in a hat too while we're at it. He's like, huh, what's going on, man? I just kind of moved in. Fucking guy. I don't even find him funny at all. Oh, how about this? What's his face? Whatever. He plays Hawkeye. He doesn't work much.
Jeremy Renner?
In terms of in the Marvel Universe.
He's going to have his own standalone. He better. It's the greatest character ever. It's fucking Hawkeye. He stole the show.
Oh my god, dude.
You're fucking actually, Avengers. He stole the show.
Are you believing your own shit that's coming out of your mouth right
he
now?
He stole the show.
Oh my god. Oh yeah, my god.
Tag? Come on.
Tag was a great film, actually. Mm-hmm. I enjoy Tag very much, if you must know.
So, I'm looking at your wall, and I'm thinking another person. Well, he might be too happy to be Drax, but John Wesley Shipp. He's too ripped.
Yeah. I give up.
Yeah. John Wesley Shipp.
No. No.
So I'm looking at your wall.
No.
Looking at the wall.
No.
I'm glad to see your guy Fillion's got his got a new show, eh? He's got a cop show coming on TV.
Oh, no. They already had its first season.
It did?
Yeah.
Oh, fuck.
The Rookie or whatever?
Yeah.
Yeah. I had a season last year.
Had a season.
I'm checking the Wall of Shame now.
Checking the Wall of Shame. Who's on the Wall of Shame that could make a good draft?
Manu Bennett.
Manu Bennett?
Come on. Crixus.
Yeah, he's not that big, though.
When he gets jacked, he's pretty good. Well, technically, Ryan Hurst, he's a really big guy, but he's not huge, you know what I mean?
What about John Cena?
What is wrong with you? Why? What is literally wrong with you?
Would that be a bad choice?
That is a bad choice.
Why?
Anything with John Cena is a bad choice.
What about blockers?
What he about made that? One good movie.
What
one
about?
Good movie. We had this conversation already, Dan.
What about the Saturday Night Live skit that he did with Jimmy Fallon?
No.
Oh, dude, it's fucking hilarious. Ew. Ew. That's my stepdad, Gary. Oh. Sarah. With no H, because H's are ew.
Oh, God, Dan. I have no words for you. I literally just... I don't even know what to say to you anymore. Right. I'm just kind of stuck.
All right. So, we're going to agree... to not decide yet on who Drax would be, and maybe here's a little teaser. The next
Perhaps.
Episode of the Droids Canada podcast, we will unveil our pick, as long as Todd agrees with it, of who should replace Drax if Drax does not decide to meet his contractual obligations.
I feel like I'm stuck with you right now.
You are.
Not in the middle.
That's a good... see what you did there.
Alright.
So does that? Tapping it out?
I got nothing left. I've given you everything.
Yes.
I'm done.
Okay. In that case, bye-bye.
Fucking bullshit! Fucking bullshit! Fucking bullshit! Fucking bastard! Fucking bullshit! Bullshit! Fucking bullshit! Son of a bitch! Bullshit, Joe Hogan!